student pilot David Lynn has 490 hours of flying experience. Jason Herman, 720 hours. Kurt Tahara has more than 1,000, including cross-country flights in this sleek twin-engine jet. In the past, all three college students would have been hot prospects for jobs at regional airlines after graduating from Purdue University's highly regarded flight school, learning on the job, much like medical residents do. Not anymore.
Did you feel like the rules were changed in the middle of the game for you?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I mean, that's just the way it is.
This is why.
My house was on fire.
The crash of Colgan Air 3407 3 years ago. It led Congress to a wholesale reevaluation of airline safety and new rules to address pilot fatigue, likely one of the contributing factors in the crash. Now, the FAA is proposing raising the minimum flying experience for a new first officer from 250 hours to 1,500. That leaves David Lynn and hundreds like him across the country in a lurch, graduating with several hundred hours of flying experience, but far short of 1,500.
I feel like right now, if I were to go into a regional airline job, I've been flying the jet. I know exactly what I'm doing now. If I go fly for 2 years flying in a small single-engine airplane, I'm going to lose a lot of what I've learned.
We certainly understand where this comes from and the concern from the accidents that have resulted. We understand that we want to have the safest air transportation system in the world, and we do.
She loves Christmas.
This is the face of that concern.
My life is changed forever, and believe me, it's not a good life.
Scott Maurer lost his daughter Lauren on that Colgan flight.
I always wondered, you know, these pilots look like they just came out of high school or certainly are well in their early 20s. You know, how much experience do they actually have?
Maurer said he was appalled to find out that a co-pilot needed only 250 hours, though both pilots of his daughter's plane had more. He helped push for the new rules. The regional airline industry and many flight schools say it's the quality of experience that's important, not the quantity of hours.
Just flying around, gaining time, people are going to do that in the cheapest, easiest way possible. Towing banners over Atlantic City, flying back and forth, back and forth.
Earning hours, but maybe undercutting the sophisticated training of a university flight school. The industry says the new rules could make it harder to hire qualified co-pilots. America's most famous pilot doesn't buy that.
I think it's really ludicrous on its face to suggest that we shouldn't have reasonably high minimum pilot standards simply because it's deemed by some to be somehow inconvenient. That really doesn't keep our priorities straight.
The public can weigh in until April 30th, and there may be exceptions for the military and some flight schools, but it's a charged debate with no easy or cheap fix. In the end, raising the standards may mean every flyer pays more.
It should mean that we pay more for it. Again, we are only, as consumers, going to get what we are consistently willing to pay for.
As these aspiring Sullies, who dream of being captains, know only too well. Lizzie O'Leary, CNN, West Lafayette, Indiana.